Let's Make Big Moves not only marked the beginning of a new year of Ultimate, but also gave us the first S-tiered event of the season. But as hype as the event was, there's almost certainly some big sets that you missed out seeing this weekend, or results that might have slipped past you, but that's where us here at ProGuides are here to help. We'll be giving you a brief rundown on all the big results from the event so you can find out exactly what VODs you should be digging around YouTube for. But before we dive into the crazy results, I want to remind you about our on-demand coaching on ProGuides.com. Our new Pro Pass grants you free passes to our Play with Pros platform, along with a plethora of exclusive content, all posted daily. Make sure you don't miss our new Pro course with MKLeo himself, a new one with ESAM, as well as others coming soon. But with that out of the way, let's start by talking about the champion of the event, Nairo. With this first place finish at Let's Make Big Moves, Nairo joins MKLeo to become only the second player in the history of competitive Ultimate to win two S-tiered events. Talk about a good way to start off Ultimate's third season. His run to do so included beating Frozen, Apollo, and then barely scraping by Wadi's Rob in a very close game 5 set to make it into top 16 on the winner's side. There he had another hard-fought set that went the distance against DaBuzz, but the victory just barely slipped through his hands, pushing Nairo down into loser's bracket. Down here, Nairo showed his insane level of insurance that comes with playing multiple Smash games at the highest level like he has done for so long. He did this by winning 3 Game 5 sets against Meister, T, and Kamehameha on his way to Grand Finals, as well as sweeping Sinji and MVD 3-0, who both had an incredible weekend that we'll talk about in just a bit. He then came face-to-face with DaBuzz yet again. Rosalina came in from DaBuzz to take 2 straight games on Town and City, putting Nairo down 1-2 in the set. But Nairo showed that clutch factor yet again by winning games 4 and 5 of set 1 and then dismantling DaBuzz 3-0 in the second set to win the tournament. To sum up his event, Nairo's loser's run here may just be one of the best we've ever seen in the history of competitive Ultimate. And if he's able to keep playing this hot, MKLeo might have to start watching his throne. Although DaBuzz still ended up having an overall pretty solid tournament finishing in second place, falling short yet again might be such a tough pill to swallow. To refresh your memory, DaBuzz has taken the silver medal at Let's Make Moves, Ultimate Summit 1, Low Tier City, and The Big House, just to name a few. And now, he can add Let's Make Big Moves to that cursed list as well. But again, it's not all negative for sure. On top of a sizable prize pot at an event in his home region, DaBuzz grabbed set wins over Raffy X, Kamehameha T, and Nairo, which is nothing to scoff at. Hopefully, he'll be able to shake off the defeat from Let's Make Big Moves quickly, because coming up very soon on the horizon is not only Glitch 8 on January 18th, but Genesis 7 as well the week after. So the ball is going to be back in Olimar's court in only a few weeks, so we'll get to see if DaBuzz gets bogged down by the losses of his past or is able to learn from his mistakes and thrive with tweaks he's bound to make. And speaking of tweaks, let's take a detour to talk about a player you might not have even realized was in attendance at the event, TSM's own Tweak, who came up short yet again with a 25th place finish. We'll be looking forward to upcoming performances to see if he can get a redemption for this unfortunately lackluster showing. His first loss came at the hands of MVD and his Snake, who has sort of been all over the place since Ultimate's release. But more commonly seen in his Ultimate career are placements like his 49th at Shine, SmashCon, and Big House. Maybe his C4 has finally clicked, as he also grabbed wins over Wishes and Dark Wizzy to finish 5th at Let's Make Big Moves, taking 2 very respectable losses to Kamehameha and Nairo. But let's circle back around a Tweak and talk about the loss that ended his run, Riddles. Ontario's number one player in Terry Main won the set 3-1 over Tweak's Wario and Wolf, according to reports, but unfortunately, the set wasn't streamed. So what can we take away from this event for Tweak? I think this pretty much cements the fact that we probably won't see Tweak completely stabilize and stop being inconsistent anytime soon. For a while, it looked like his 33rd at Smash and Splash 5 was just a one-off tournament, and most of the community was willing to just write it off as such. But I don't think that's quite the case anymore. It could be something he has to work on with his mentality. It could still be him in a character crisis, doubting himself on which character he should be using in some matchups. It could honestly be hundreds of different things, but the results we can expect from Tweak moving forward still stay the same. He's still one of the game's most talented players, but we really don't know which tweak is going to show up on any given weekend, which is something I don't see changing anytime soon. Let's shift gears to a more positive note to talk about the young Link main, Toast, who went on the best run of his Ultimate career by finishing 13th at Let's Make Big Moves. The highlight before this event was nothing to scoff at either, as he was able to defeat Raito's Duck Hunt at Just Roll With It 11 back in June, but a run of this caliber blows that one set out of the water. His big wins include Ling Ling's Peach sweeping Void's Pichu 3-0, and also sweeping Wishes' Joker 3-0 to eliminate him from the event. What I think is the most important of these wins, and has me excited for Toast's upward trajectory in the future, is the one over Void, as the pair met in bracket all the way back at Evo, where a Void still in the midst of a character crisis was able to beat Toast no problem. Why I say this is the most important, despite the fact that Wishes was the highest of the three seeds of the event, is that this is a concrete example that Toast is improving rapidly at Ultimate, as he completely flipped the script against a top 50 player. So be on the lookout for Toast to continue to overperform his seed at major events, and be ready for a potential upset if he meets either of the pair who eliminated him from this event. Tweak and Meister, both of whom he was already able to steal a game from. We briefly mentioned seeding in that last section, but we've still neglected to mention the number one seed at Let's Make Big Moves, Samsora, who greatly underperformed with a 9th place finish. But using a placement to determine how good a player's performance was at an event is a dangerous pitfall Smash fans have been falling into since the dawn of time. When you look and see that Samsora had to play and got swept by T's Pac-Man in Winner's Quarters, and then dropped down to immediately play Meister's Game & Watch in Losers, it all starts to make sense. Both of these characters are widely considered some of Peach's worst matchups in the entire game, and Samsora has historically struggled against both of these players, so he honestly just fell victim to some terrible bracket luck. He beat Cosmos and Jackal at the event, and I don't think this should really change your perspective on how good of an Ultimate player Samsora is, especially with how strong his second half of 2019 went. But you won't just have to take our word for it, because we'll be seeing Sam compete in a few weeks at Genesis 7, so hopefully he'll have better bracket luck next time. And although T did benefit from a bit of bracket luck getting to play both Samsora and Blazing Pasta's Peach on winner's side, his run to 4th place was far from handed to him, as it included beating Light's Fox 3-1 in top 128, and reverse 3-0ing Mars in one of the most exciting sets of the tournament. There's so many great moments from that set that I'd urge you to check it out if you missed it. However, the best moment by far is when the pair are tied at 2 stocks apiece in the final game of the set, and T's got a bell in hand. T keeps toggling his shield on and off, waiting menacingly right on top of Mars and shield, waiting for him to do something. And Mars gets scared, plays right into T's hands, and loses any chance to win the set at exactly that moment. However, T wasn't the highest placing Japanese player at the event, as Kamehameha finished right above him at 3rd, also being knocked out of the event by the two Tri-State players defending their home turf, Nairo and DeBuzz. The Mega Man and Wario main did for sure reap the rewards of MVD's upset, allowing him not to play Tweak. But he had to win some incredibly difficult sets to even reach the point where he would have met him. Meister was his first obstacle on that course, knocking the Game & Watch down into losers to not only end Sam's run, but to hand a second loss to Anti, who had probably his best run in Ultimate so far, beating Rydia, Big D, and Epic Gabriel. Then in top 16, he gave Mars his first heartbreaking loss of the tournament by also reverse 3-0ing the Zero Suit main, like T would later do. That was followed by then playing MVD in place of Tweak, winning 3-1 and sending the Snake down into losers before being sent there himself by DeBuzz and eventually eliminated by Nairo. And lastly, before we finish off this video, let's run rapid fire through the results of some of the biggest names at this upset-laden event. Leon, Bowser main in 14th seed at the event, finishes 33rd, being knocked into losers by the Florida Rob main Epic Gabriel, and then being taken out of the event by Venia, a Greninja main from New York, defending their home turf. Gabriel and Venia both went on to finish 25th, with Epic Gabriel losing to Anti and Laid, while Venia beat Fruit well before being knocked into losers by Kamehameha and nearly clutching out a Game 5 set against Jen. Raito's Duck Hunt Dog missed matching the success of his fellow countrymen by a long mile by finishing 33rd at Let's Make Big Moves, being buried in the bracket by two Rob mains, Raffy X and Zomba. Mr. E's Lucino wasn't even able to make top 64, or the portion of the bracket where he'd get to play best of 5 sets, as he lost 2-1 to Spargo's Cloud and Winners before receiving a killing blow from Jules Robin to finish an incredibly disappointing 65th. Louis Money's Fox doesn't seem to follow the lore from his source game, as he was escorted out of bracket by two Wolf mains, Smock from Montreal in Winners and Larry Lur from California in Losers. And maybe the return of Pichu isn't really going to happen, as Rydia finishes 97th, losing his final set of the event 2-0 to Zero to None Zelda, and Arfang also finished 97th, being knocked out by Sharp's Sheik. And that about does it for ProGuides' recap of Let's Make Big Moves. Let us know in the comments below which sets from the S-tier event that you enjoyed watching the most, as well as which of the tournament's many upsets caught you the most off guard. If every Ultimate tournament in 2020 ends up being as wild and packed with talent as this one, we've got a hell of a good year of Ultimate ahead, and we at ProGuides will be here every step of the way to make sure you don't miss a second of it. Make sure to subscribe to ProGuides and put those notifications on to make sure you don't miss out on any content on the competitive Ultimate scene in the future.